this woman is definitely in the Hall of Fame when it comes to rappers. Somebody who was a female MC or is a female MC, but will whoop you in your ass. And she gave it to everybody. I want everybody to show your love and appreciation for Roxanne Shante. Hello, how are you doing?
I'm absolutely great, brother dear. How are you?
I'm all right, man. I'm all right. I'm good. So listen, good. Again, if you're just tuning in, we're talking to Roxanne Shante. Every night at 7 p.m., 4 Pacific, I go live. That's going to change next week. But for right now, for the next couple of days, every day, 7 p.m. Pacific Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, I go live, current events, news. I let you go on live with me. And, of course, we have celebrity interviews like Roxanne Shante. If you are not following me, follow me, but hit the notification button so when I post, you know exactly who's coming on the show. So let's start here. What was your first experience with hip-hop?
I have to say my first experience with hip-hop would have to be in Queensbridge Public Housing, which is the largest housing project in the world. And it would be going to the park, going to a place that we call River Park, because it was like the park by the river, so we called it River Park. And going there to Park Jams, that was my first experience. That was the first time that I can remember hearing beats like Trans Europe Express and knowing, like, that's what I'm supposed to do.
Right. Have you ever lost a battle? Because you're known as a battle rapper. Have you ever lost a battle?
No, I haven't.
Never lost a battle?
Never.
Okay, who's the person that gave you all that you could handle? There had to be somebody.
I would have to say it would have been not all that I could handle, but someone that was able to truly keep up would have been Supernatural.
Supernatural?
Yeah.
So wait, hold on, you battled Supernatural?
We were in a, it wasn't, I don't want to say it was necessarily a battle, more so than a challenge of skills. And he definitely was able to keep up. Like, as far as being someone that's also able to do a freestyle at any time, you know, I would have to give it to my hip hop brother Supernatural all day long. So I don't know if you want to call that a battle. I just want to say someone who I knew was had the same superpower. Listen, maybe just not the same cape, but the same superpower.
Supernatural is really, really good. Like, yes. When it comes to off the top of his head, that guy is an absolute genius. Is there a rapper that you just owned when you battled them? Because I want to start with your battling, because that's what you're really known for. Is there a rapper that you just absolutely owned every time you battled him, walk in the park?
I would say everyone else.
Everyone else?
Everyone else was really a walk in the park. I guess because you would take it that at the time, they, one, weren't ready for me to be a female rapper. They weren't ready for me to be so young. And they weren't ready for me to have, you know, off the head type of skills where my freestyle was truly something that was off the top of my head. So a lot of times they would say, no, let her go first. And even if I went first, that still gave me the advantage. And then if I went after you, you know, that made it even worse, because now I can take bits and parts of your lyrics, tie them into what I'm doing, and, you know, just walk away. So
you were known, and this came from DMX, and this also came from Snoop. Those are two of the greatest who ever grabbed a mic, that you would not have anything to battle somebody with. You would come to the show, and whatever was happening right there, you would battle them right on the spot with that.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think that would be the reason why when I would show up at certain park jams, or I'd show up at certain concerts and show up at certain venues, you know, automatically either they want to be very, very nice to me because they didn't want to be the victim, or they would try to figure a way to keep me from being inclusive. So I guess sometimes when you walk around with, and I like to call it a certain type of superpower, but when you walk around with it, you know, people see that coming, and if they're unable to deal with it, then they will try to, you know, keep you out of the loop, keep you out of the circle, try to make you not be involved with things. And I'm sure there's a lot of people out there with great talent who can also identify with that, that you can be really good on your job, and somebody who's not as good as you will stay close to the boss's door to keep you from getting in.
Mm-hmm. You know, did you ever battle any male rappers with songs? Because you were at the beginning, not the actual beginning, but right at the start of the golden age of hip-hop. At that time, there was only a certain amount of rappers, and most of them were male. Did you ever battle any of them?
They, no. No, my battles really took place in the clubs with people who felt that, you know, they were either just coming up or they were a great neighborhood rapper or they represented their borough. I think it was mainly because so many of them were already in the industry and no one wanted to have that loss on their belt. And I can respect that because, you know, you can't just come to a fight and fight the champ. You got to go through everybody else before you come to the champ. You know, right. You just don't get that shot. You know what I'm saying? You got to go through your whole ranks. And then as I'm coming through the ranks, I guess, you know, they'd be like, nah, look, we're not going to do this. We need to take this turn here. We're not going to do battle rapping. And I was like, okay, that's fine with me. You know, but you're also not going to put me in a position or put me in a box where you think I'm not going to say what I want to say when I want to say it. And I think that truly is just the Roxanne Shante way. So because I'm not able to be controlled, as far as, you know, they couldn't control me with a record deal because that didn't make me any difference because I made more money outside of that. So because when you're uncontrollable, then they don't have no guarantee of what you're going to say. So they kind of, you know, have a little fear of that, I guess.
You know, you were naming dudes by name in your raps. Like this was territory that was unheard of. I mean, even today, in today's world, as much as we've got advanced, dudes always sneak this. You never sneak this to anybody. You said people by name. Why did you go so hard? What was the reasoning?
Well, because I didn't believe in subliminals. And subliminals can be mistaken because the wrong person could think that that's about them. And I never wanted that way either on record or in real life. So if it's about you, you need to know it's you. So I need to say your name. I don't want anything to get confused. I wouldn't want somebody to say, oh, if she said this, I think that's about me. No, I don't want you to think it's about you. I want you to know it's about you. You know, I grew up in the largest housing project in the world. We didn't do subliminals. If your problem was with this person, because so many people might have a similar name, you can't just say, oh, I got a beef with Mike. There's 10 Mikes. Right. You need to say Mike from building 16 on the fourth floor, you know, right, in order to make sure, because you mess around and catch you with Big Mike. And that wasn't even the Mike he was talking about.
Right. So with that being said,
yes,
did you do it because you felt like I'm a female, I got to go extra hard? Or what was the reasoning? Like, what was the reasoning to just lash out like that?
Well, because I was told that in order to be the best, you needed to beat the best. And it wasn't about being a male or a female rapper. It was about being a great rapper. So in order to do that, you need to go for the greatest. Why would you even bother to try to hit, you know, the leg or the toe when you can go straight for the head, you know? And that's just what I did. I felt that that's what I was supposed to do, whether being a male or a female. But I represented women to let them know, like, look, we're out here. And if we're not just as good, we are better. And they needed to know that.
Okay. Who is the best battle rapper that you ever heard? The person that you think is the best when it comes to battle rap?
I don't have one. I do not have one. I can't say that there's one person that I consider to be the best battle rapper, period. I cannot say that. Now, I mean, most people will say, well, why don't you choose yourself? You know, being Roxanne Shante, I'm just a whole different entity. I'm not going to say I'm just this the greatest battle rapper ever, because you do have some great battle rappers. And I can sit here and say, oh, yeah, well, you know, I've watched this one. You know, I've watched Ice. I've watched quite a few people. But the main factor is rap battles today are a little different and a little hard for me to judge. Not that I'm not entertained by them, not that I don't love them, and not that I don't respect their craft, but the main thing about it is that they have so much time for preparation. You know, in order to impress me, I need you to just walk up and not know who you're going to battle and take it from there. I don't need to know that you had 3 months to learn about this person, to dig into their life, to find out. I need you to walk up, just meet them, or maybe just get a few great battle rappers together, put all the names in a hat, shake the hat up, and let everybody just pick a name, and then let that person do it. Then that's a little more of my level of battle rapping.
Right. I mean, today's battle rapping is a little different in the respect that it can get really dangerous really, really quick.
Absolutely.
Coming from battle rap myself, it could get, it wasn't as dangerous back then as it is now. I remember years ago, there was a competition called As One, and I battled a rapper called Red Rum, and I got in his ass. And that was the first time that I encountered a beef from doing that. You know, and that was like in the mid, the late 80s going into the early 90s. It was never like that. Now it's like, again, dudes are, it's more advanced. Dudes come with like 30, 40 people. And dudes are getting up in each other's face and this, that, and the other. And I just feel it's such, it's much more dangerous than when you were doing what you were doing. Back then it was for the culture. You said what you had to say and you went home. But now I just feel like it's just so much more dangerous. It's so much more at stake. It's social media. If you diss somebody, Shante, we're going to talk about it. But if somebody get dissed now, it's all over Instagram.
Absolutely. That's the world that we live in now. Like back in the day, if you got punched in the face, you got punched in the face. The only people who knew that were the motherfuckers who was there saw you get punched in the face. Now, they're going to tell a story for a little while, but then after that, that's it. Now, you're constantly getting punched in the face. That same punch is relived over and over and over again. And for the person who got punched in the face, they are going to feel it because it's a constant reminder. You know, we were raised like, look, okay, you took your loss. Now you go back out there. But now it's like you take that loss, but you take it constantly over and over and over again. So, yeah, I can understand, you know, to the level that things have gotten today where it can be a lot more dangerous. But you also got to understand, too, that we come from different locations. Some people come from, you might have a great battle rapper that comes from a block that only has 10 people. And then you might have a great battle rapper like myself that comes from Queensbridge that has 30,000 tenants.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's just not fair. I think maybe even if they put them in a location, let them do it, and then that's it. And it's, you know, and let it be done. Almost like being a gladiator, you know? The difference between a gladiator and a boxer, both great. But we understand that a gladiator, it was a totally different time.
I you know, like you said, you summed it up. You summed it up. The bottom line is that how many people do you have, this?
And yeah.
Social media, like you said, back in the days you got punched in the face, you died once. Now you come and you getting punched in the face got 17 likes. When you come back, the shit got 343,000 likes. Like, fuck, everybody saw this. So I do agree with you. I do agree with you with that. Now, how were you able to actually stand out and make it as Roxanne when there were like 7 Roxannes at the time? Roxanne's sister, Roxanne's cousin, Roxanne's neighbor, everything. Like, how were you able to stand out and be the one that was finally standing at the end? Fatman Scoop!